So today I'm going to show you how to insert, update and delete data in database in PHP and MySQL database. Since a newer version of Apache and PHP do not support MySQL extension, I'll be using MySQLi. So MySQLi is improved version of MySQL. So let's move to our tutorial video. First of all, make sure that your Apache server and MySQL database is up and running. If you are using Windows, you can use XAMPP. If you are using Linux, you can use XAMPP. Or you can, if you are using Mac, then you can use MAMP. If you haven't installed any of these, then you can download XAMPP. I will put the link to download XAMPP in my description below. So I'll start my Apache server and MySQL. So my Apache server and MySQL database is up and running. Then I'll create a root folder or project folder in my local dixie where I have installed my XAMPP. So double click and I have installed XAMPP on local dixie. So I will go to XAMPP and stdux and create a new folder here. I'll give its name test, and to do this project I'll be using a text editor called PHP Designer 8. You can use any text editor like Notepad++ or Sublime Text. So I'll open my text editor and link my project folder in my text editor. So this is PHP Designer 8. So I will just link my project. So go to right click on personal project and new and link to local folder, then PC, then local dixie, then XAMPP, then stdux, then test. Okay, I have linked my project in my text editor. So I will just create a new file that will be this file, and I will create a file called index.php. So first of all, I will just design UI for my project. It will be a simple design where we will insert first name and last name and then show it in the same file. To edit the data, we'll create a new file. So let's create a HTML document. Doc type HTML, then HTML head. Title, insert, update and delete in PHP and MySQLi, then body, CD header, class header, delete, then division. I'll give its class main. So adding, I'll write inside s2 tag, last name, then S2 listing all the names and then footer. All rights reserved and copy and copy 2017 to Vijay Thapa. So let's look how our HTML file looks like. So just go to the browser. I'm using Chrome browser. So let's localhost 18. I have changed the port port in my XAMPP. If you haven't changed your port, then it will be just localhost slash your file, that is folder test. I have changed the port, so I will have to give colon 81. So this is how our project looks like. So just let's give a little bit of styling. For this I'll go to my text editor, and here I will write the CSS to my project. This is the internal CSS. First of all, let's header, give the CSS for header, that is I will make its background color will be black, and its font color will be white, and padding I'll give padding of 1% on all side. Then I'll just align the text to center. So let's look how our header looks like. So this is our header and it looks nice. Let's design others too. It has its default margin, so it is blank inside, so I will just change its default margin to 0. To change the default margin, I will just put asterisk, then margin 0. So now it has removed the default margin and padding. I'll apply the same CSS to the footer, so I'll just copy it and paste and change header to footer. So our header and footer looks like this. Now we need to apply CSS for our main content dot main. I'll give its width to 80%. Then border, I'll give border of 1 pixel. Solid black. So let's look how it's look. So it's up to here, but I need this division in center, and I'll apply some margin on top and bottom. So margin top to 1% and left and right is auto, so it will be on center. So this is how it looks. Let's give a little bit of padding. I'll give 3% padding on one side. So now it looks beautiful. Let's create a form to insert our first name and last name. Let's go to the main section. Here I'll create a form tag. Its method will be post, and action will be, just leave blank for now. I will specify a file for that. So here I'll create a table. Then tr td first name last name. No, I have to insert input type here. Input type text name is equal to name. Thus I will copy this tr for last name. Just copy it and paste it here. So I'll change it is first to last, first to name. I'll make another row tr. So td I'll leave it blank. So nvsb gives a space on this column. So again I will create input type submit button. Submit, its name will be submit and its value will be add member. So let's look how our input form looks like. This is how our input form looks like. So to list all the names, I will create another table. Here I will just break it and hr for horizontal line. So hr gives this horizontal line. Again br for a little bit spacing. So it has it looks nice. Let's create another table to display all the details here. TH, it is table heading. So SN means serial number. Then TH first name, last name and actions. In this column there will be update and delete button. For now let's fill dummy data. Later we will select all the data from database. So th1, then th my name pc, then Thapa. Here we will have two buttons to update and delete. So just give a link and this here create a button type button update and has type button delete. Let's look how our table looks like. This is how our tables look like. Let's give some border so it will be separated. Instead of 2 ts, I should have given td, so it will not be bold, it will be regular. So it's now regular. This is bold. TH means table heading, TD means table data. So table data is regular and table heading is bold. Let's give some border on all sides. I will go to header and inside the style tag table tr and th and td. Just give border 1 pixel solid black. So this is how our table looks like. There's spacing between each cells, but I do not want the space between cells, so I'll just merge it by border dash collapse. So now it looks fine, it looks beautiful. Then I'll give padding 1%. Okay. Okay, this is nice. Okay, so we do not have anything here, so I'll just put a placeholder here. So let's go to my first name input type, placeholder first name. Again, last name, placeholder last name. So we can see first name and last name here. So this is it for adding and listing all the data. So we to update our name, I will create another form. For this, I will create new file and edit.php. Rename, I just missed dot, so this is it. So I'll just double click and copy all and paste it in here. So I will not need to list all the database and all the members from our database, so I'll just delete this and I'll just leave a form adding not updating and change my heading to adding first name first and last name to updating first and last name. So this is it. So we have designed our edit page to edit.php. So this is our I will change the input type submit button's name to update member. So this is our update page looks like. So when we click on update button from our home page, it will come to this file and the first name will be displayed here and last name will be displayed here. If when we make change to our first name and last name and click on update, our first name and last name will be updated and redirected to home page. For now, let's just move to our home page. So in this episode, we have designed a form to add our first name and last name and display it in our table. We also designed an update form to update our first name and last name. In the next episode, we will create a functionality to add our first name and last name and insert it into our database. So in this second episode of our tutorial series, we will add a functionality to insert our first name and last name into the database. So let's move to our tutorial series. Add our functionality to add member. For this, I will create another file called add_action.php. In this file, we will get the values from our input fields and store into our database. So let's go to the home page and in our form tag on action attribute, we will just give the name add on the action, that means action.php. so when we click on add member button, it will go to the add.action.php page. Let's check if the link is working fine or not. PHP then echo add action page then semicolon. Okay, I'll just click on add member page. If it's working fine, then it will display add action page. So it is working fine. So in this page, first of all, we need to get values from our UI. So I'll just communicate this line. So get values from UI Let's declare the variable first underscore name is equals to dollar underscore post. Since we are passing values using post method, we will use dollar underscore post to get values from our UI. So first name, this is the name we give in our input field. So let's go to our home page, and in this form we have used method is post, and the name is first. For first name, input type's name is first name, so we are transferring this first name to our add action page. So this first name holds the value from our home page, that is first name. So similarly, we will get values last name dollar underscore post. So we have obtained value from our UI. Let's echo it to see whether the data is successfully obtained from our UI or not. So I'll just reload it and type my name, first name, and last name is THAPA, and click on add member. So I can see Vijay and Thapa. Vijay is my first name and Thapa is my last name. So we are successfully getting our data into the add action page. After obtaining the data from our UI, we have to connect our database. Connect database, I'll write a code to connect database. Just declare a variable, then mysqli underscore connect, then localhost. Since I am running this project in my localhost, I'll write just localhost. If you are running in on a real server, then you can give the domain name, that is www.something.com. Then username for me is root and password is blank. This is it. Then die error. This part will help to get a message if we have any error on connecting database. If we don't have any error on connecting database, then we will not get any message. So let's check out if we have successfully connected our database or not. So we have successfully connected our database. Similarly, let's select our database. Select db is equals to underscore db. I'll just give a connection we created earlier, connecting, then database name. So we haven't created any database yet, so we will have to create a database in our server. So I'll just go to localhost 81, then type phpmyadmin. If we haven't changed the port number, then you can delete this 81 and colon, then hit the enter. So it will take us to the phpmyadmin page. So click on new, and I will write the database name. Test is my database, will be test. So create. Then we will need a table to store our database. I'll give tbl underscore users as my table name. I will need just three columns. One will be user ID, that is ID. Another will be first name and last name. First name will ID will be integer, first name will be varchar of length 50 will be enough, last name also varchar and 50. Then we will make ID as primary key and OK and auto increment. Then save. Here we have successfully created our database and TBL users table. In our TBL users table, we have ID, first name and last name. ID is primary key and auto increment, so we do not need to insert any values on ID. It will be automatically filled sequentially. So let's move to our project and select our database. So we have created test database. If connection is failed, then die error. So let's check out once more. I'll click on add member. So we do not have any error. So we have successfully connected database and selected a database. So let's write SQL query to insert data in our table. For this, I will create a variable called SQL. Then inside the double quote, I will write the query to insert data. Insert into table users. Table users is our table name. And set, and then we'll give the column name. First name is equals to single quote. Then inside single quotes, just copy this and paste. Then comma. I love to write on next line. Then name is equals to single quote, then just copy this last name, double click copy and last name. So we have successfully written our SQL query to insert data. Let's execute the query. Create a variable areas result. I will create a variable, then MySQLi underscore query, then connect, then SQL or die underscore error. I'll check if the SQL query has executed successfully or not. If dollar result is equals to true, then query is successful. That means our data is successfully saved in our database. So I'll just echo message to test if whether the data is successfully saved or not. Else echo fail. So let's check out our project. I'll just go to my home page, then insert my name, first name and last name, and click on add member. So we have successfully inserted our data into database and it is showing a success message. So let's go to our database and check whether the data is successfully inserted or not. I'll go to my phpMyAdmin and select on browse. So we can see my first name and last name is successfully inserted into database. Instead of showing message here, we will redirect to home page after the data is successfully inserted. So I'll just comment out this and redirect to home page. For this, I have to write a code, header and location, and location is index.php. So when the data is inserted successfully, it will redirect to our home page. Let's check out if it redirects or not. Look, it is redirecting successfully to our home page. So we have successfully inserted our data to the database. Let's check once more. Vikas Guru, I remember it has successfully redirected to our home page. Let's check if our data is inserted or not. I will just click on browse. So we have successfully inserted Vikas Guru. Since I refreshed the browser, it has inserted a blank rows too. In here we have to display the data we have successfully inserted in database. For this we'll go to our text editor and we'll go to our table of listing all the names. After the first tr we will write the code to list all the data. So I'll start a php, insert php. I'll just copy the code to connect and select database from add action page. This is our connection and selecting database code, so I just copied and pasted here. Then I'll write SQL query to select data from our database. Select all, asterisk means all, so select all from tbl underscore users. Then run query dollar result is equals to mysqli underscore mysqli query, then dollar con, that means connection, then dollar sql, that means sql query, or die underscore error. If query is successful, then we need to display our result. Here result holds all the data from database in an array. So we will use a while loop to display all the data. So while, inside while loop, we'll declare a variable and fetch all the data. Fetch underscore SOC dollar result. As I said earlier, dollar result holds all the value from database in an array. So we have to get all the value from result. So I'm using mysqli underscore fetch underscore SOC to get all the values from result. So I'll just create a variable that is id is equals to dollar row, that is this row, then row, then type the column name, no, this is id, then first name is equals to dollar row underscore name, then last name last name. After creating and storing our data from database into this variable, we need to display this variable in a row and column. So I will just copy all this and put it here to display. So I'll just end my PHP here and cut this part too. So so it will display all the data in our table. Here I will have to start PHP, then echo dollar first name, similarly PHP echo dollar last name. repeat and let's see in our browser. So we have successfully listed our data in our database, but the serial number is showing 1. We have to generate it automatically. It should show 1, 2 and 3 serially. For this I'll create a variable called $sn is equals to 1, then I'll just increase it with 1. For this I will php then echo $a++, so this will display in serial wise, that is 1, 2. On line 88, I don't know what is the A. That is A. That is not A, that is SN. Save it and just, this is a 1, 2, 3. So we have successfully added and listed our data into the column. Let's add another one, that is Sagar Guru, then add member. So it has successfully added the new member. Similarly, I'll add another one, that is Pramit and Das, and click add member. So we have successfully added our data into the database and displayed in our form.